Deborah Mailman has long been a legend of Australian TV and cinema. From The Sapphires to her actor and Logie award-winning performances on Offspring, Secret Life of Us, critically acclaimed political drama Total Control, and so much more. This Aussie star knows how to captivate an audience.
But in her latest role, Deborah will be taking us to a soothing place. Let's have a look.
Grey-green leaves and otherworldly flowering cones are like no other trees on Earth. But here, along the coastline, everything is perfectly at home, including you.
Whoa. Deborah Mailman joins us now from Wollongong. It puts you in a zone, doesn't it?
I'm like... it's really exciting to be part of this. I've never done anything like this before, and so it's an Australian first to be part of the Headspace app. And these are essentially audio-guided bedtime stories. And I'm reading a story that's created by Australian author Claire G. Coleman. It's called Rolling Dunes. It's set on the southern coast of Western Australia. So these sleep casts are designed to create the right environment for people to drift off to sleep.
Oh, I can see why. You fit the bill perfectly with your reading of it. It's unlike anything that you've ever done before, though. You've been on our screens since the 90s when you were in Radiance, for which you won your first AFI, now known as the Actors, for which you've won many, many Actors and many Logies. Deb, I'm interested to know, what do you think are the biggest changes that you've noticed in the industry over the last few decades?
I think certainly representation. You know, there's a lot of amazing, talented First Nations writers and directors in the industry right now. So I think there's a lot of opportunities for our mob to be telling our story in the way that we need to tell our story. So that, I think, really, that's been the significant shift that I've seen in this time, is just having that representation for us as First Nations people.
Oh, it's incredible, isn't it? And to be alongside Steph Tisdall and...
Yes!
Yeah, in Total Control, I mean, that was just brilliant. There were some amazing one-liners there. I think my favourite was two powerful black women coming through as you're charging through Parliament House. What was it like filming in Parliament House?
Oh, it's fabulous. I mean, we could not have made this show without that access to location. And I'm glad you mentioned darling Steph Tisdall. I mean, she's such a wonderful talent, and we've been really lucky to have a lot of sort of new and emerging artists sort of join us in this story. But yeah, no, it's great. As you can see, Wayne Blair, who also directed the season two of Total Control. But it was great. It's such a unique and powerful story. I'm so proud of the show. And yeah, to have that access to Parliament House was amazing.
Oh, well, you are absolutely awesome in that as well. Can you tell us a little bit more about teaming up with Headspace and Sleepcast? I think it's great. I'm trying to get my head around how you can do the sleep voice. How difficult is it to slow down?
It is. Look, it is. As I've mentioned, like, I've never done anything like this before. So there's a certain technique that comes with you know, creating that environment where you are encouraging people to shut the chatter away from their mind and to put them into a space that is calming and relaxing, that eventually allows them to drift off to sleep. I mean, when I was reading it, you know, the direction was to go slow. And even when I thought I was going slow with the reading, I had to go even slower. So, you know, it's very specific in the technique, and even with the breathing exercises that I take people through with Claire's stories. There's a certain rhythm to it, but I loved it. Because I'm a big fan of these apps as well. Meditation has been part of my life for some time now, so to be on the other side was really thrilling.
This might be a silly question, but are you, like, do you have to think of as a character when you do it?
Oh, look, to be honest, I think what's really similar in terms of this script that Claire's written and any project that I do is you just sit with the words. And Claire's created such an evocative script of the landscape in southern Western Australia. Really, it's just allowing the words to speak for themselves.
Oh, it's so beautiful to listen to, and it really does remind you of how much slower you should probably...
Oh, tell me about it.
..go to be able to meditate. Deb, in the last few years, ASMR and recorded meditation has become so popular. Everyone from Jake Gyllenhaal to Cardi B have done it. Your voice, from what I understand, is going to be the first Australian accent on the app. That's a pretty big honour.
It's a very big honour, yes. As you said, Nerelda, Australian first, also with Eric Banner as well, who's providing his voice. So, you know, I think Headspace app has over 70 million users globally. So for Australia to come in and be part of that space and to sort of evoke our Australian landscape and stories, it's really a huge honour.
Yeah. Deb, getting back to the industry that you are so... loved for. What's got you most excited in the next few years ahead in terms of stories that are being told, content that's being created, people that you will potentially be able to work with, or people that will be able to work with you, should I say?
Well, yeah, look, there's a couple of projects on the horizon that I'm really excited by. I'm sorry I can't speak about them too much just yet. But I mean, fingers crossed that that'll all sort of come to play. You know, waiting on word of Total Control 3, so I've got my fingers crossed for that.
Yes.
But at this stage, it's the life of an actor, you know, you sort of, I'm enjoying the time that I'm not working just to be at home with the kids. They start back at school soon, so that'll be a busy time for me anyway. But, yeah, there are some exciting projects coming out, hopefully can be announced towards the end of the year.
Oh, well, could one of them possibly be Offspring? Fans are desperate for a season 8. Do you think it could be a possibility?
I don't know. I think it's done and dusted. I mean, I think, you know, we had such a seven seasons I think we did on Offspring, and, you know, such an amazing show to be a part of and great family of actors and crew that we're a part of. But, yeah, it feels like that's put to bed now.
I'd love to see a reboot of Secret Life of Us. What do you think of the possibilities of that, Claudia Carvin? Amazing. That'd be wonderful.
Do you want a bunch of 50-year-olds in a share household in St Kilda?
Actually, speaking of 50-year-olds, you're approaching a milestone birthday. How's that feel?
Yes, this year is my big 5-0. So it's interesting watching that footage that you were playing early in the introduction. I was just looking at it going, oh, my goodness, I look really young.
You still do.
Yeah, you absolutely. Awesome. You are absolutely radiant. You know, you started with radiance, and you are still absolutely radiant. I think we are interested in seeing a bunch of 50-year-olds.
Watch you in anything. There could be a Sapphire 7 coming out, and I'd watch it. I love it.
Oh, goodness.
Deb Mailman, we absolutely love you. Thank you so much for joining us on Studio 10 this morning.
Oh, pleasure. It's so lovely to talk to you. Thank you so much.